Another day, another episode. We've just taken Gordium over from the Persians last episode. We're also beating Darius by quite a few points now, and I think it'll stay that way now because we're just too far ahead for them to catch up, and we will win this because all we have to do is just take over the capital. Because I used to think that you had to destroy the whole empire, but thankfully you just have to destroy the capitals if we check victory progress. Two players are still in control of the capitals. We have destroyed everyone else, so that's pretty amazing that we have done that much. And the Persians only had their island all to themselves, which is crazy. It's so unfair. But we will win. Let's just check our demographics as well. They have a lot more soldiers than us. Almost double. Not exactly double, but almost double. We're beating them in crop yield, gross natural product, and also the land, obviously, because we basically own two continents all to ourselves, especially the second one that we've colonized. As the graphics just render out just then rather awkwardly. But let's head back over here, and I was an asshole last episode, leaving it us into this episode right now to go into the next turn. So let's go ahead. Gordium's looking a bit uneasy right now, even though it's got 97 combat strength. They do have these mechanized infantry, which are rather strong. So, oh, we might hold out. Oh, 34 then. Oh, yeah. I guess that answers that. I guess they took Gordium over. But that shouldn't be too bad because, see, the AI is rather stupid in terms of, like, once they capture a city, even though we have massive amounts of troops around Gordium, they still all leave, basically. They could have all moved up over here, but they choose not to. So, we've got to take over Gordium now. We have a lot of units which have gained some XP, so let's just go for accuracy one so they get some better scores on the open ranges, which are pretty much all over here. It's a couple, like, over here, it's really weird. It's like all dusty desert type terrain with massive amounts of like rocks and mines and all that good stuff. Lots of trading posts as well that they have over here. So let's just continue on with this episode right now. We have, I want you to be better against land units actually. What else? We got a bomber that's also can gain in XP. Let's go for siege one. And I'm going to tell you to go over and attack Gordium. Also, we have a couple of cities under attack. Just check Utique. I'm not exactly sure if you guys want to see the animation still, because the aeroplanes do take quite a while. I think the animations add a bit to it, and they do drag on the episodes, and the episodes do get a bit longer than I had hoped for. Especially last episode. Last episode was like, what, 40 minutes, and YouTube had massive problems rendering the video out so it would be 720p. It was processing for about, what, 6 or so hours, so it is 720p now. It's like, I always upload my videos to 720p, always. Like, I promise you guys that. Just build a bank over here because I want to spam units over here so we can, like, protect ourselves really good and build walls and castles back up again because they took over Gordium. Bastards. So yeah, it really sucked. Actually, I think I have a couple of, yeah, there we go. We have a couple of aircraft over here as well. So as I was mentioning, whatever I was mentioning, I already forgot. God damn. This game just always makes me forget everything. But what was I saying? I was talking about something or other. Let's just continue on. It'll come back to me. Let's bring back some bombers over here. Unfortunately, this guy's unexperienced or inexperienced as well. So it's not good against our cities. These guys are though. And we'll be able to take them, actually. What I need to do is, because I don't have any melee units over here either, that's a bit of a worry because these battleships are all range units. The tank's the only hope that I have. So I'm going to move him in over here because he can't take Gordium this turn. So I'm going to tell him just to stay out of Gordium's range. We have this bomber. I'm also going to tell him to attack over here. And now I'm going to tell these... Okay, you're good against land units, so it's probably going to help us out over here. And what you're good against, nothing, or bonus against cities, but you're pretty much good against nothing else, so you could attack this carrier. Oh, that's also a pretty decent target to destroy over here as well, so I should choose that soon. Actually, we have these. Oh no, you've already used your moves, haven't you? Unfortunately, you have. We've got this bomber over here. I'm probably going to tell it to heal up. Nah, I'm going to tell them to heal up, actually. You guys should just attack Gordium, just so when they heal up next turn, they'll still be really, really badly injured. We have a fair amount of money. Oh, I think that's what I was mentioning, money. Oh, I can't can't believe, like, it just escaped my mind what I was just talking about. I'm trying to remember. Anyway, we have this artillery, and it is going to be OP very, very soon, because as soon as we level up to level 6, then we will have the ability to go logistics, and which will enable us 2 turns a move. Or maybe 2 moves a turn. I think that's the way that they want us to say it. So we'll be attacking Sardis, because attacking cities gives us 4 XP, whereas units gives us 3 from memory. So Sardis actually makes quite a bit of damage as well. Congrats to you guys. We have some extra guys over here. Build a trading post for more money, because I want more money. And you guys should probably come up. Oh, you can't, can you? Just attack over here. I'm going to save up my money right now, because, as I keep on mentioning, I don't want to buy any more units. I do want some melee units, such as tanks, just to come back over here, just to support me. But I'm not going to do that just yet. Who else needs orders? Oh, there's machine gunners. I'm going to tell you to actually come by over here. There you go, that should help us out. You guys should work on a farm. Okay, in Amsterdam. Amsterdam's coming along nicely. We still have 1 unhappiness. Why is that, though? Because we don't have any, like, it's just mainly our population. We do have a rather large population. Let's go into the next turn in again. And I think Gordian was still in, it was still unhappy, whatever they call it. It wasn't unhappy. Oh, God, some planes over here. Oh, hello. This bomber is deciding to attack our, these guys, these, what are they called? The machine gunners, that's what they are. So, oh, hello. Oh. That's no good. They decide to move in their SAMs over here, so we probably have to use our rocket artillery on this city. And then we'll move in our tanks and we'll be able to capture it, which is going to be very good. Also built computers. Actually, let's just check what we're working on now. Robotics. Okay, that's nice, which will enable us to buy missile cruisers. Although, to be honest, it's just going to be a land battle right now, because as soon as we capture both Sardis and Ecbatana, we'll go through Susa to Persopolis. At least that's the goal. Okay, so. I do want you to attack Gordium, don't I? Yep. Alright. And then I'll tell these ships over here to attack this carrier. Actually, I don't think we'll be able to destroy it just yet this turn. You guys should have as well. You guys should disembark over here. We have a couple of planes, which I'm not going to tell you to do anything just yet. I'm going to tell this tank to capture Gordium, which we will do successfully right now. Hopefully. There we go. Annex the city. And actually, let's just check the demographics again. 274 to 468. So we are gaining and they are losing. So that's a great sign to see that we are gaining some more units. We have these bombers which are ready to move. So let's tell them to actually attack these mechanized infantry just for the sake of attacking. We also have a couple of guys that can upgrade, and we have Utik that can attack. Where's Zurich? Oh, it's all the way over here. Jeez, you guys came up quite the distance, didn't you? Okay. Also, it's interesting how this... Oh, that's actually kind of cool. If we check these oil rigs... Where are they? Just zoom back out. There they are. Because we have 7 and they only have 3, we have like more of these oil wells getting oil up. That's really cool. I really like that little feature. Actually, there's 7, actually. So, what, this has only 1? I thought it has 3. It does have 3. What's that? It's 4? That's 3. So, that's 7. This only has 1. One little oil... I don't know what you'd call that thing. An oil well. I'm sure there's some specific scientific type of name for it. Let's head back over to Gordium, and we should... Well, unfortunately, this tank can't move. Everyone's pretty much used up all their turns except for these bombers, which we can tell to attack. Which I'm going to tell all my bombers to actually attack. Also, I should mention that I do have the live stream ability on my YouTube channel. Unfortunately, because I was an idiot and I uploaded a nude mod on Skyrim, I have like a channel. I don't know what they call it. Like a channel. I don't know. It's not a copyright claim, it's like a channel just breaking community guideline rule, that's what it is. and I'm not able to live stream just yet. So I will be on August 11th. I have that enabled now, but they block it, the ability to live stream like live on my channel because I broke that rule. But whatever, no less, I will be live streaming very shortly. Also, I did buy XSplit and I've been testing out Twitch TV. Unfortunately, my internet isn't as fast as I had hoped. I'm only going to be able to upload about 980 kilobytes per second, or kilobits per second, sorry. Is going to be the bitrate, so it's not going to be too good. It should be okay, but it's not going to be absolutely fandangled, best quality. Unfortunately, where I live in Sydney, we don't have like the national broadband network, which is going to enable us to stream at or get internet at extremely fast speed. So I'm going to have to wait up a little bit for that. We can choose some production in Gordium. Let's go for the courthouse. It should be one more turn. Yep, one more turn for resistance. So that's also good. What do we buy here? Finished a granary. So let's go ahead and build a stadium just for some happiness. Can never have too much. As I keep on mentioning, the problem with this is all these guys that finish their production. City is so good because look at that, 41 production. They build things really quick. Let's build a stock exchange because you can never have too much money. And you guys should also work on a stock exchange, and that will work. Okay, so we have some bombers, no doubt. Yep, that want to move. Let's tell them to attack these guys. Get rid of some of that artillery. You gotta love the oldie faithful. Oldie faithful. Because it's blocking everyone off. So like, if the Persians were able to use these like three tiles up here, like actually these four tiles, this and that, basically like to enter our territory, or at least these three tiles over here, like to be close to Gordium, then we would be screwed. Thankfully that's not the case. They block this area off so only ranged guys can attack. So this rocket artillery is going to be a big help. Okay, we've got more planes, which I'm going to tell all of them to actually just attack. Okay, someone else needs orders. Hopefully these guys are going to be the last ones, although I doubt it. Oh no, it's okay. That's going to be it. And we'll be able to head over into the next turn. And yes, we are. Okay, so they heal up. We'll be able to destroy them soon. Maybe even move in our tanks, although I don't like this. We have to move in our battleships in range. Thankfully, these guys are blockading them to Gordium because they might actually have been able to take it. Also, I'm not like recording this so it happens in a positive light for me, so like everything happens well for me, so we're at an advantage each episode. I don't record like that. I record 40 minute episodes or so. I'm gonna try to make it shorter. Oh, I think that's what I was talking about, the lag. Oh, we got a policy, and we'll be going for populism, which wounded military units inflict 25% more damage than normal. So that's going to be very good over here because a lot of these guys are injured. Actually, none of them are right now apart from this tank, but yeah. So yeah, I already forgot what was I going to talk about. God damn. I woke up too early. Like I went to sleep at 4 a.m. because I was testing out the live streaming all the time, like trying to make it run smooth, etc. And then I woke up at like 8. So I'm running on a fuzzy brain, which is no good, but so who should we attack? Probably just get rid of these guys. Now I'll move my tank just over here. I'll use it as a pretty much a sacrificial unit, probably. I should tell these guys to come up over here, shouldn't I? So you guys come up, attack. You guys come up, as long as you're out of range of Ectobana. Really weird name. And okay, we aren't able to destroy that just yet. You aren't able to move up like so, but you're able to attack them. There we go, that works. Also, what I should do right now, quick smart, is because I have all these mechanized infantry around, I need to purchase a fair few things, such as a pair of walls. Look at all that money we got, that is so good. Walls. Wait, what did I just build? Purchase an arsenal? I went for castle, that's good. Okay, and we're going to be actually able to build a military base as well. So that definitely helped us out. We have a couple of these planes Probably going to tell these guys... Actually, you don't need to heal up. What am I talking about? Oh, shite. Oh, I so deserved that. That is just crap. That is ridiculously bad. I should have really thought better. Really. What was I thinking? I didn't look around. Because I shot these guys down. Oh, that's such a shame. Oh, well. Gonna have to tell all these guys to fortify themselves until they're healed. Well, that sucks. You guys are gonna have a minor defeat, so I'm gonna tell you to fortify yourselves. You guys go ahead and work. Oh no, you actually have completed that. So come up over here, build your trading post. Can never have too much money. We have Utique that can attack. Oh, it's gonna be close to destroy these guys. So yeah, I don't record, like, so it's all positive for me and everything happens the way I want it to work out. I record 40 minute episodes, so could you imagine, like, if something happens that doesn't, that's not good to me, that's not positive to me, and I have to start re-recording. That is just the most ridiculous idea ever. Just because I'm doing better than you guys thought I would be doing doesn't mean I'm, like, cheating or anything like that. I have played, like, ahead, obviously, because this is just addictive as all hell. And we are trying to do... trying to win this, after all, and as I mentioned, like, we don't keep on re-recording this or whatever. I only do one take, and that's it. Whatever happens, happens. And they are extremely close to taking Gordium. They have a lot of units around here, which I don't like. They've completely surrounded Gordium. Oh god. What's gonna happen of me? I really don't like this. Thankfully, cannons don't do too much damage and all that good stuff. Okay, so we have a unit being promoted. You guys should probably be good against land units as well. So I'm going to tell you to attack them. Okay, so that enables me to move you over here. And then we'll be able to have you guys over here as well. Let's attack them. Hopefully we'll be able to clear it all of you out. So you have done your moves. You guys attack them. Okay, you attack them as well. Okay, good work, Gordium. Now, these workers, come up over here. Stay out of trouble though, try not to get captured. Unfortunately, I'm not gonna be able to do anything with my bombers just yet. You know what, actually we will be able to do something. We'll be able to attack Sardis. There we go. That gives us something to do. So I'll make it a bit easier to capture Sardis when we most need to. And we can purchase something over here. I'm going to go for a pair of tanks, I think. Tanks should be good. We have another bomber over here. I'm not going to tell it to do anything because... Actually, no. Keep on attacking Sardis, actually. Even though I could have told you to heal up, I want you to attack Sardis. We have something that can build, also Utique. Okay, Utique stun the... No? Oh, Uxmal. I thought... Utique and Uxmal... Utique had two things to do, obviously. Uxmal has something to do as well. Let's go ahead and do something to do with money, such as a bank or something. There we go, bank. We have some other places that can build stuff. Let's see, anything to do with money? I think you're all done with money, aren't you? Let's go ahead and actually build a military base then. 19 turns. Hopefully we would have finished this game by then, because we'll still have a lot more moves though, probably than 19. We'll have to wait and see. It's 1984. I think I started this episode at 1980. So I've gone only 4 turns. I do want to keep them rather short now as well, because YouTube has had a massive problem processing the video to 720p. Oh, and mobile views. That's always another problem. You guys couldn't watch this video or the previous video on your mobile. I'm not one of those view whores that only allows monetizable views or whatever. Like, because you can't monetize mobile views. So if you were like watch on a mobile phone, companies that do like networking, etc., that don't get paid for mobile views yet. But I'm not actually able to talk about like monetizable views, etc., in more detail, because you do sign a non-disclosure agreement. Anyway, let's continue on with our artillery, who have already used up their moves, and I can't really do anything, so let's just check out these plans of your own. Okay, you know what, let's just leave you. Okay, let's just head over into the next turn. I don't want you to attack Sardis. Oh, we have this destroyer. Oh nice, we've got a destroyer. Destroyers are really handy. come out all the way over here, four turns. Hopefully you're gonna be, yeah, you're gonna be out of range of all the other city states. So head over into the next turn now. It's gonna be tough on Gordium this episode. Actually, they only have a couple of units that can attack us. Where the hell did that come from? That was so strange. Somewhere up over here. Over here. Why are they invisible though? That makes no sense to me. Well, they're getting close to taking Gordium again. I don't think they will though. I think we should be good. These tanks will be able to attack though again, no doubts. Let's see. Hopefully they shouldn't be able to take it. You guys are going for my tanks. Okay, at least this... okay, we're all good. That was weird how it worked out, but... Oh, they have definitely turned and turned for the stupidity, though. Look at the stupidity. They put so many units in the ocean. Put them on embark mode, so they're going to be easily destroyable. I really need to heal up Gordium quick smart, though. That's going to be very sketchy how Gordium ends up working out, but we should pull through. See, I'm not... Like, I don't understand why you guys... Some of you guys... Well, it's actually not that really that many... But some of you guys absolutely just have just keep on digging into me just playing this game. I have no idea why, but okay. So I'm gonna get you to attack them and you to attack. Okay, so they're all destroyed nicely. We are able to use our planes right now, it seems like. Yep, it's all clear. How good is that? That is such a good sight to see. Now who should we attack? These guys. And you can come up here. Hopefully that's not going to use up all the turns, is it? It shouldn't. Okay, you should move back. Oh, you can only move back over here. Oh well. And then this tank can attack them. Even though it's going to be a major defeat, it's still going to be all good. So we can heal up. Okay, so we've done that. Now, let's start bringing in a couple of these bombers up here. You guys already attacked. Come on. It's poor effort. You take. Who should we attack? Actually, we get a bonus because they are on horses? No, no. They're on incense. Do we get bonus if they're on incense? They're in a desert. I guess maybe that's why. Terrain modifier. It's in our favor. So let's go attack them then. It's going to be a bit easier. We have a fair amount of money as well. But, you know, who should we attack? Get this bomber to attack them. I wonder if this helicopter gunship can attack us. I doubt it. No, we're not. Well, they can attack us, obviously, but see how much damage it does. None? Oh, no. Ah, that's nothing. Ah, that's pretty good. Even though we didn't really do too much damage to them either. Let's bring this carrier over here. Oh, not this carrier, but this bomber over here. You have a couple of moves. You attack Sardis just for the extra XP. So next move will be upgrading as well. You, which is going to be great because you will be definitely overpowered. And once they are able to attack twice a turn, then they get XP like twice as fast, which enables them to level up even quicker, which the next one I will go for will be so they can attack one plus attack range. So they can attack over four tiles, which is just overpowered to the max. Especially when they can attack twice. Let's start bringing some more planes. Just destroy these riflemen. You guys coming up? Yep, you're finally coming up. So yeah, I'm definitely looking forward to live streaming. Very much so. I still have to work a couple of things out, but I did pay for XSplits, and it seems to be actually very, very good. All the other live streaming things that like I trialed out, they are absolutely hopeless compared to XSplit. It's so far ahead of the market. It's pretty ridiculous. But they do like pay, you do have to pay well for it. So I guess it makes sense that it's good. But Wirecast is also, you have to pay for it quite a bit, but it's pretty shocking compared to XSplit. And compared to like, to if you want to do gaming. Wait, let's just go ahead and bring this bomber over here. Bomber, I want the bomber. Why is it not bringing fighters out? I guess we must have used it. Oh no, we destroyed it. Oh God, sometimes I worry myself. Derp! Yeah, destroy them. Okay. So we are producing a lot of money. Next time we'll be able to build a military academy, which we aren't able to just yet. They just love how the rockets like went over Sardis and didn't actually hit us with the animation. It only did 5 damage and we destroyed them. Someone else needs orders. I'm going to tell you to heal up. And we're able to go into the next turn now. Definitely pulling away from Darius. Let's go into demographics as soon as his turn finishes. I think they're pretty much all given up. Removing like their last couple of tanks in, aren't they? That's pretty much all they're going to be able to do, just moving their tanks. There we go. No, they didn't capture Gordy. And let's check soldiers. Well, we went down, but they're going down as well. We're definitely over double them now. So that's great to see. Thankfully, we have these bastards to intercept. We destroyed their bombers. Nice. We just destroyed 2 of their bombers. Score 1, Arsenalrobert. Look at all that faith we have. Like, I really could start buying some more faith units, but it's, I think we're guaranteed to win over here. Like, as much as you guys hate to admit that, I think we're guaranteed to win over here because, like, Sardis is almost crumbled. Gordium's close to crumbling, but as soon as this turn is over, we'll have more than enough money for a military academy. And, of course, it heals up. So, let's just choose to gang up on someone. Well, this is going to be an obvious victory. Let's just see. Alright, actually it doesn't really matter what we do, so let's tell you guys to attack them. I'm going to tell you to actually... Okay, we're going to have to bring in both of our battleships in here, which is cool, to destroy them completely. And then we're able to like to bring in all our planes as well. You... I don't know, what should I tell you to do? You can't actually reach them, so you just attack them, because they're the only melee units. Look at that. They're at 319,000 units. 319,000 units. They might actually be less units than us after this turn. All these guys are promoted. Well, look at that. Yes, plus 1. Oh, that is so good. You guys go siege 2. And you... Oh, look at that. More logistics. That is just going to work out so well for us. Also, tell me if you guys want to see me live stream something else. Also, another thing that I wanted to talk about this episode is End of Nations. I bought the game. I just got to the ability to play just then, like right before I was going to record this episode. So it's finished downloading and I'll be able to play it. Unfortunately, it's under a NDA agreement as well because it's a closed beta. So I don't think I'll be able to post any gameplay up, even though like they allowed Total Hell, but they're basically like Total Hell, but such a asshole. That's putting it mildly. Just can't stand him. But they allowed Total Halibut to live stream it, and he's uploading lots of videos for it. And he's giving it, obviously, biased reviews, whatever. It's a long story. I'm not really going to get into Total Halibut. I can't stand him at all. It's one of the, like, the worst YouTubers you'll ever know. He's such an asshole as well. If you see like some of the things he writes to his viewers as well, it's pretty crazy. But, alas, oh well. So yeah, he's able to play it. So good on him for being able to actually upload videos of it. I'm trying to. I'm emailing the publishers, tweeting at them, whatever. This is a shameless Twitter plug as well. So you guys follow me on Twitter. Even though I really don't post that much. Oh, you don't have a stock exchange? Go on to one QuickSmart. Okay, so more units need orders. No doubt it's these guys. So you go ahead and destroy that tank. So they're out 319,000 units or soldiers. We'll see after this turn. It's definitely going to be a heck of a lot less. Also, we're able to bring this bomber in. Oh no. Why is there 3 aircraft stationed here? We haven't gone over the turn that these guys have been destroyed yet. Wow, we must have been playing this for ages then. Okay, you destroy them, which is going to be 1 turn. All happening very quickly, very nicely. No, you didn't destroy all of them. I bet you they only have like 1. No, they still have a fair amount of health. Alright, let's bring in this bomber then. There we go, you should destroy them. And I don't think we're going to be in range for them, are we? I don't want to bring garrison up all my aircraft in Gordium just yet, just in case something negative will happen. Although, what I do want to do is actually move my guys up here. You guys have all attacked. So what I'm going to be able to do is purchase a... Oh wow, I've already purchased a military base. Oh wow, that happened a lot quick. I already forgot that. Okay, then let's go ahead and build some barracks. Build an armory. And then we'll be able to build another tank over here. And then we'll be able to upgrade a lot quicker now as well. So let's go for planes, open terrain, one, and shock two. So we're going to be absolutely epic on planes now, which covers most of this area right now that we're trying to defend. Someone else needs orders. You can't attack just yet. So I'm going to tell you just to come up over here now and heal up now. And the next turn we should be able to actually capture Sardis. Tell these guys to attack. It's actually going to work out really well for us. Tell another couple of bombers to keep on attacking Sardis. This rocket artillery will be able to upgrade the turn after this one. So we're going to end this episode rather soon. It's going for about half an hour or so. Tell everyone to keep on attacking Sardis. These guys, okay, and you keep on attacking them and we'll capture definitely next turn. And Sardis, another city, bites the dust. And also, there was a turn. They had like 9 aircraft over here, like 9 air units in Gordium. The Persians, before we even started our attack on Gordium, they had about 3 nuclear missiles. It was just crazy. 3 atomic bombs or something. It was so, so crazy and good that we actually managed to capture Gordium while they had all those things garrisoned up in Gordium. Definitely helps us out a huge amount. And we've got more planes attacking coming over. Just check how things are happening over here. Building a lot of... Oh wow, we are building a lot of banks over here. Everywhere almost. Stock exchange over here as well. But wow, almost every place is building banks for us. So we're at 362 gold a turn now, which is slowed down because I think it was like 500 plus. A bit earlier. Planes still coming up? No, that's it. Okay, head over into the next turn. See what's going to happen. This destroyer is coming up. They're bringing their cannons against our tanks. We should do basically no damage at all. That does so little damage, it's crazy. Now we'll be able to bring this tank in. It won't be able to get destroyed, so that's going to be good because we're on a road. So we'll be able to come up here real quick, capture Sardis, and it's going to be all done. Let's just tell these guys just to attack these cannons if you can. It's an easy attack. Should happen a lot quicker than I thought. You might actually be able to destroy these guys. Wow. That was pretty good. So what? They were at 319,000 units before. They're going to lose a lot of soldiers this turn as well. Let's tell you guys to attack. You're going to be able to upgrade next turn. We have these guys. Go for shock one. And now we're able to capture. Look at this. Capturing Sardis in 3, 2, 1, off we go. Definitely annex that city. We're 6 unhappiness. That's self-explanatory. Move this tank over here. They're blockading this, whatever. And this actually has a harbor as well, I should mention. So that's going to help us out a great deal with Gordium and every other city because they've all connected their cities to roads. So that's going to help. Oh, the game seems to have crashed. No, oh, it's all good, I hope. I hope. No, it's not all good. Wait, I'll be back. All right, so we're back and I think it should be working now. It's smooth, 30 frames a second. So let's just continue on. We've just captured Sardis. We can't attack here. Another unit is able to level up, whatever. I'm gonna start telling all these guys to start moving and rebase into Gordium now. Yep, move over, rebase. Actually, I'm able to tell one of these guys to come up over here as well, just in case something happens that we don't want. Like they nuke us, I doubt that'll happen. Head over to Gordium. Alright, that should be it. And we have this carrier, which I will tell just to come up over here and then go to sleep. We have this tank. I'm going to tell you just to stay on alert. We have this tank as well, which captured Sardium for us. So these workers, unfortunately, aren't doing anything. Have you built that farm? I guess you have. It's a bit brown. I guess it's all good. I want to move these guys up here, but I have no doubt Manila's going to capture them. First world problems. And I don't have any units up here either, do I? Nope. Alright, so let's just take that risk. I'm gonna have to take that risk. And okay, you guys just hurry up and finish whatever they're working. I don't really care about great people anymore at all, because we're basically guaranteed to win. You can't attack, but I have no doubt you can. And you've almost destroyed the Hong Kong mechanized infantry, and we're still doing good with our health bar on Utique, so that's a great relief. Sardis, you work in a courthouse, whatever, and we're able to go into legitimately into the next turn. But before we do that, let's go ahead and purchase some mobile SAMs, and they're going to be able to upgrade as well. So go for drill and go for drill two, just in case they bring up some bombers up against us, so we're able to defend and protect ourselves. Why would you even bring some? Actually, that was well worth it. Look at that. How good was that? We only just did that, and wow. What a bunch of idiots. I'm surprised the AI would even have thought of doing that. But, what? The enemy has been spotted. It's only these guys. It's a couple of riflemen. Nothing really to worry about. Look at that. Yes! Logistics one. That is just so good to look at. Alright, so now let's get ready to attack Ekbatana. Start moving these guys up here. Start moving these guys up here. They can't move too much, can they? So we probably should attack them. Yep. Just destroy these riflemen. Check the demographics. Oh, we're so close to beating them in terms of armies. And then I'll do it. Yep. Shame. Shameful display. You guys finish them off, and we should be all good now. Yep. That's great to see. And okay, so this is going to be the last turn of this episode. Let's tell you guys to go better against land units. I probably should have done whatever you're good at against cities, though, shouldn't I? You're able to upgrade. Let's see. Someone to help us out with cities. Oh, may heal damage outside of friendly territory. 15 health points healed per turn. That's pretty good. Plus one range, plus one movement. I'm going to have to go with Bombardment 3, to be honest. Because we are, I guess we already have the improvements against cities. You take an attack and actually hopefully finish them off, and you're able to finish production. You know what? You guys start working on Ekbatana. Even though I can destroy this carrier, even though I'm not going to. Okay, we're working on Ekbatana now. Our tanks, I'm not going to tell our tanks to do anything just yet. Apart from moving up here. Alright. That's all good. We can choose some production. Alright, Utique. Go ahead and build some walls, actually. Choose some more production. Rotterdam. Oh, bank. I'm surprised you guys haven't even started building a bank either. Oh, we do have some military units up here as well. Gonna tell them to come up over here. Okay, we can choose some... Okay, we can tell these guys to come down over here, I guess. Actually, you know what? Attack this carrier. It's going to be a major victory, so that's a good start to see as well. 21, 31 damage, that's good. I thought the destroyer would be a little bit better than that. Kyoto, you work on a stock exchange. We're still making $373 or so, so it's not too good. You guys get to work in a public school because that's what they recommend me. You guys should just stay on alert. Now we've got these bombers, which I'm going to tell just to come up to Ekbatana and hopefully destroy that soon. Actually, we'll be able to capture it really soon. These guys are unable to capture it just yet, but they will be soon. I love that they can attack twice. Logistics helps us out so much. Okay, we better watch out for our health as well on our bombers, because they're dropping down real quick. Attack them. Okay. Should I tell you to attack? I'm going to actually tell you to heal up, whatever. And I will have to end this turn right now. So we captured one city, Sardis, and we've basically pretty much kept it because they have pretty much no army. It's only they got these aircraft carriers, which is pretty stupid because they don't have any aircraft on them. They're just there, just wasting time and space and money and all that stuff. So Horus needs orders. These guys build a trading post. These tanks, I can't tell them to come up just yet. They were able to capture next turn though, no doubt. So I'm going to tell you just to stay on alert. We're able to head over into the next turn. I'm going to be an asshole because knowing me, if I click next turn, we're just going to keep on playing. And I want to keep these episodes a little shorter so YouTube can actually process the videos correctly so you guys can watch the videos. And with that being said, another episode comes to end. Come back tomorrow where we'll probably actually might even win. We'll probably capture Persepolis maybe next episode. We've got three more cities to capture, including Ecbatana, which is a guaranteed capture, and then Susa, and then Persepolis. Susa's actually got less health points or city damage points, whatever they're called, than Ecbatana. So, see you later, guys.